Hopefully he doesn't have Bloodsoaked Champion turn one. That card is quite powerful. Alright, I'm gonna keep. Obviously that's good to see. Bloodfell Caves. It means he just, if he has Bloodsoaked Champion, he just can't play it. Chief of the Edge. Well, that's annoying. Obviously, I want to play a swamp here so that I can bluff getting my hate played death touch so I don't get attacked for three. But if I were to play a swamp, then I couldn't play a morph on turn three, which is really like a disaster. So I guess I just get owned because I might come into play tap land. This would never happen in a two color deck. How do you not play a card on turn three? Not even a banner or a morph? I got off easy on that one. Also, that's where my Chief of the Edge went. Would have preferred that guy was in my deck. Mardu Charm, yikes. Kind of surprised he didn't make 1/1s to eat my Mardu Hateblade. They would have been 2/1s too, because of his chief. Stopper. Well, this is almost certainly ride down, but I just have very little choice in the matter. Playing out the Alabaster Kirin here so that I may put counters on it with Armament Core in the future. Having a Vigilance creature with the counters on it is better than a standard creature with the counters on it. Also, it uses my mana nicely so that I can leave up black for the Hate Blade, makes my opponent's attacks less attractive. Just does lots of little things that I like, and the cost is not huge. Hate Blade, sure. And the guy gets counter. Wonder if I should put both counters on the Kirin or just one. All right, I'm in for both. Just so much better for my clock. And given the way my opponent's deck is constructed, I don't think that he has kill shot. Obviously not this turn because he doesn't have any white mana, but my point is like he's extremely aggressive, has like ride down and rush of battle. It just doesn't seem like kill shot would be a card that my opponent would prioritize in a draft. Yikes. Kind of just want to block this with armament core. Is that weird? Right, I'll take it. I'll take it this time. Hopefully I draw land next turn so I can play both the cards in my hand. Yep, very good. I'm just gonna attack with both my creatures. Seems like a really sick attack with Armament Core. I can't get blown out too badly next turn, and getting him down to 8 means my 4/5 flying creature is even more relevant. Hopefully no rush of battle would be irritating. I would still probably win this game, but I wouldn't be happy about my position after this. I also feel good about the armament core attack because I got it in at a really inconvenient time for my opponent. Like when his death touch guy was tapped and he outlasted his 4/7. I got to hit him for 4, which was hugely relevant because he went from 12 to 8, and now he's just, after I attack him next turn, he's going to be dead on board. What is this? Shambling Attendant? Necropolis Fiend. Well, I am still beating that with just the board. Because my Kirin has Death Touch because of Mirek Nightblade. So that's good. What's not good is that I traded off my Morph and then drew a green source for the Hooded Hydra, but additionally, I would have had to wait a turn to get it. I would have taken two that turn and two next turn, which is really problematic for me. And at the time, I had so few green sources in my deck that would have helped me facilitate it that I think it was a reasonable play. The question now is what to do with this Mirek Nightblade. Should I outlast? I think I probably should. Yes, I should. Why do if I tap a swamp and then I click on the Nightblade, why does it ask me what black mana to pay? And Modo's like, how much of your one black mana to spend on your one black mana ability? So the reason I did that was I think it's unlikely to matter in the short term, and just having an extra counter is going to be relevant on the board later. Like, let's imagine a situation in which next turn I attack with Alabaster Kirin, my opponent blocks with Necropolis Fiend and gives it -1/-1. They're going to trade. So when that trade happens, I won't have a Death Touch creature in play anymore. And I would have wanted a Death Touch creature against that Salt Road Patrol for the next turn. Obviously, that point is made moot now because he drew a thing that gives it first strike, but there was a moment there where it would have been relevant. Wow, he passed turn. That was a really, really gross misplay, I think. If he had attacked with Salt Road Patrol, my options were either take it or block with Kirin. And if I blocked with Kirin, he could give it -1/-1 with that thing. So I think he missed 4 damage there. What do I do now? Should I wait and try to top deck removal for Necropolis Fiend, or should I just trade off with my Kieran? Think waiting's bad. Or waiting is good, I mean. I think trading off makes it so there's less cards in my deck I can draw. I'd like to just draw Murderous Cut and just get it over with. If I was my opponent, I might have just shrunk my Skull Hunter there. I mean, it makes it problematic trading off with the Kieran, but that's only assuming that no card were to be put into his graveyard for the next turn. Maybe I should have held Skull Hunter on the off chance that I top deck and Hostilities. That might have been a really clever play. Here's that Salt Road Patrol attack that I was dreading. Reasonably confident it should have happened last turn as well. But now it's really bad for me. Think I should just take it. Yeah, I'm just gonna take it. Flooded Strand. Pretty good draw for him. Pretty great draw, actually. Really bad draw for me. Think I'm just gonna attack with Alabaster Kieran. The reason for that is I need to get that Necropolis Fiend off the table so that he can't kill my Mardu Skull Hunter and then leave me with one less jump blocking creature. Yep. Trade. Like, I have to just chump that Salt Road Patrol next turn. I also think it was a bad error that he didn't evolve his Einok Bonkin. Oh, because he had Ponyback Brigade. Well, I just die. Yeah, pretty annoying. Hard to pinpoint the exact reason why I lost this game, other than he had better cards than me. Oh well. Good games. What could I draw? Right of the Serpent, I could have drawn a couple turns for lethal. Feet and Hostilities. Murderous Cut. Throttle would have been nice. Oh well.